G'day and welcome to Accelerate Maths. In this lesson, we will learn inverse proportion. Inverse proportion compares two quantities. As one quantity increases, the other quantity decreases in the opposite direction. For example, if we work at a faster rate, the job takes less time. For a dance party, four workers can set up the stage and lighting in 3 days. How long would it take 6 workers to do the same job? How many workers do you think will finish the job in the least time? 6 workers, of course. More workers take less time to do the same job. Okay, first we multiply to find the total to do the job. 4 workers taking 3 days means that they take 12 worker days to set up the dance party. But with more workers, the time to do the job will be less, so we divide the total by 6 workers to get an answer of 2 days to do the same job. Travelling to the party at 80 kilometres per hour takes 5 hours. If the car travels at 100 kilometres per hour, what time does it take? Okay, to find the total we multiply. Travelling 80 kilometres per hour for 5 hours is a distance of 400 kilometres. But more speed means less travel time. So we divide the total distance by 100 kilometres to get the final answer of 4 hours. Let's do the same question in a more formal way using the rule for inverse proportion. K divided by X equals Y. Remember that in inverse proportion, as one quantity increases, the other quantity decreases at the same rate. The rate at which one quantity increases while the other quantity decreases is called the constant of proportionality. We use the letter K as the constant of proportionality. First, we write the information from the first part of the question. Right now, k is an unknown number that we have to work out. X is the speed, so x is 80. Y is the time, so y is 5. K divided by 80 equals 5. Let's multiply both sides of the equation by 80. This means that the constant of proportionality, K, is 400. In the second part of the answer, we'll use the inverse proportion rule again to find the travel time when the speed is 100 kilometres per hour. K divided by X equals Y, but we know that K is 400. X is the speed, which is 100 kilometres per hour. When we divide these to find Y, Y is 400 divided by 100. So Y is the same 4 hours. It takes less time, only 4 hours, to travel at the fastest speed of 100 kilometres per hour.